Hello everyone, welcome back. Wanted to share an interesting flat earth discovery in the Bible, and it's something my wife actually came across the other day when we were looking into who it was that decided which books belong in the Bible, because we've always been told that the King James Version is the one that's the most accurate, and we wanted to find out, or she really did, this was her idea. I was kind of impressed that, you know, that she was wanting to go this route and find some answers to who decided which books belong in the Bible. We know, of course, King James, but why, who was this guy, why did he decide that, and what's wrong with the other books, like the Book of Enoch, and why were they certain books removed and certain books kept in the Bible. And we came across a different version of the Bible, sort of a newer one, but I wanted to share what it says about creation, because it's quite interesting, and explain a little bit about it. But here it is. It's referred to as the CJB, or the Complete Jewish Bible, and it's a translation for Jews and non-Jews alike that connects readers with the Jewishness of the Messiah, so that the names and the key terms are returned to their original Hebrew and presented in easy-to-understand transliteration, enabling the reader to say them the way Yeshua, or Jesus, because his name wasn't really Jesus, but the way that he did. So I thought that was really interesting. It's a newer version. I know there are tons of versions, and I don't trust a particular version, just like I don't trust a particular model of the earth just yet, because I am waiting for the Father to show me the truth about everything. I don't want to take someone's word for it or put my trust in the wisdom of this world like we have all done our whole lives, and I encourage you to do the same. So I'm not saying this version of the Bible is correct and accurate compared to any other version, but I thought this was interesting. You can read more about it, but I wanted to share with you the Genesis chapter 1 version of creation in the CJB. So here it is. It starts out exactly the same as the traditional Bibles that you've read before, where it says, "In the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was unformed and void. Darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God hovered over the surface of the water. Then God said, let there be light, and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and God divided the light from the darkness." So very similar, nothing's changed. But it says here, "God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. So there was evening, and there was morning, one day. God said, let there be a dome in the middle of the water. Let it divide the water from the water." That's where it gets interesting. Let there be a dome in the middle of the water. That's pretty cool. I thought that was pretty cool. And let it divide the water from the water. God made the dome and divided the water under the dome from the water above the dome. That is how it was. And God called the dome sky. So there was evening and there was morning the second day. God said, let the water under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let dry land appear. And that is how it was. God called the dry land earth, the gathering together of the water he called seas, and God saw that it was good. That is really interesting, guys. I think that the fact that he's translating it into the way that pretty much the Jewish people would have said the words, and he's doing it that way. I don't know anything about this guy or his intentions, but this was back before the flat earth movement. This isn't somebody who goes, hey, the earth is flat, let's translate the Bible to agree with that. I'm sure this person believed in the globe and made this Bible just using the words that were customary to the Jews that held on to these texts. So pretty cool. And again, I'm not saying this is a version of the Bible that you should live by or anything like that. Just wanted to share it with you because I thought it was interesting. Wanted to see what you guys think about it. And some of your answers, if you've been on this quest to find truth and all of that, and you've been seeking truth wholeheartedly, really want to see what you guys think. You guys have been showing me some really cool stuff. Just reading the comments and things that you share, the wisdom you share. We're all in this together. We need to be kind to each other. The people who believe differently are not our enemy. It's the ones who are forcing the lies onto the mainstream and into the media and everywhere else to further deceive us in the future. Those are the enemies. But someone commenting and saying that you are dumb for believing a little differently, they're not your enemy. Be kind to them. They don't understand where you're coming from. We understand where they're coming from because we were all believers in the ways of the world. We saw the world anyways, the way that the world wanted us to for many years. And it's not our fault necessarily. I mean, it kind of is, but you believe most of what you're told by the people who teach you things because they aren't, in their minds, they aren't lying. They're telling the truth. Your teachers did not believe they were lying to you. They're not part of some plan to deceive you. They care about you. So when somebody that loves you and cares about you is teaching you stuff, you're going to believe it. Okay? So I've taught things falsely without knowing it, and it's okay to do that when you don't know, but when you do know the truth, it's no longer okay to lie. And that's kind of the challenge that I have as a teacher, and probably many teachers who are waking up out there, is how to teach without misleading young children and young minds, and also without getting fired, because the powers of darkness do not want the truth spread. So we kind of have to stay in hiding a little bit for now. Not as bad as the old days, you would think, where they would burn people and burn the scriptures that they had with them and all of that. But that stuff has gone on, and I always wondered kind of like with the Holocaust, when they were burning books and doing all of that, killing people, were they just trying to hide something? You know, maybe some certain text. Who knows? But there's a lot of things I want to look into. And again, need to work together, need to be kind, love each other. Only here for a short while, and we need to get to know the Father a little better, because this world, or a lot better, because the world's lied to us about who He is and who we are for long enough. So it's time to spread truth, spread love, know the grace is going to win. Stop condemning yourself and living really sad. The price has been paid. Freedom is just around the corner. You can be set free from whatever it is that's holding you back, whether it's lust, addiction, no matter what, you can be set free. You can be healed. Okay? The Father loves you. We love you. We're all here for you. So reach out to us if you need us. Send us an email if you don't want to comment, if it's something personal or whatever that you're struggling with. Reach out to us, guys. We're here. So take care of yourselves. Again, be kind. Thanks for tuning in. God bless.